You know, think of how cool that must have been after all these years, after all this time, for him to finally put on a Leafs jersey.
I know! What a great night for Colin Blackwell. Hey, when did the Leafs get Mark Giordano?
Let's go!
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a little ridiculous.
Good boy.
Play all the hits! Left Toronto Maple Leafs. Let me finish. How am I supposed to go to bed after watching that?
I'm quite hyped. With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Puppy Ziggy, do you have any criticism of this jersey?
Nothing. He has nothing at all.
That was a no-look. High five for the no-look. No?
Wow.
Leafs win 3-2 over the New Jersey Devils. But first, can we talk about the jersey?
I gotta say, I know some people hate it. I understand why you hate it. I kinda love it!
To everyone who hates this jersey, she is very gorgeous to me!
You know what? I don't even care. This is great. You know, watching it on TV, I was really confused, I'm not gonna lie. But wearing it? Oh yeah. For some reason, something about it screams Lego Batman, but I love it!
Oh, and it's reversible. Saw some people saying that it looked like a Bruins jersey. No, that's damage that's irreversible. I kinda like this too, though. Just as a gimmick. As long as you understand it's a gimmick.
What about the fight strap?
Well, I don't know, isn't it silly? Oh yeah, that's the silly thing about it. It's a reversible hockey jersey!
And the reversible Leaf logo is like a smiley face!
Corny jerseys don't realize they're corny. Fun jerseys are weird on purpose. I repeat, she is very gorgeous to me!
What do you think? Leave a comment in the comment box down below.
If you haven't seen today's episode of the Steve Dangle Podcast, wow, screw you too! If you have seen it, you'll know that Adam and Jesse got me this as a belated birthday gift, and I cherish it. And then the Leafs are taking on the New Jersey Devils at home for a late next generation game because COVID ruins everything. They're taking on the New Jersey Devils on the second half of a back-to-back. That should be an easy dub.
That means tonight is gonna be exhausting.
That means they're gonna lose. They're gonna lose the one game they wear this jersey in a heartbreaking way, and I'm never gonna wanna look at it again. Look at the white jersey, the stadium jersey that the Leafs had from their outdoor game against the Washington Capitals. Honestly, that jersey's fine. It's fine. It's okay. I know Jesse loves it. Me? I hate it. And you know why I hate it? Because they lost like 6-2. I remember watching that game. It was a tremendous waste of time. And this, a Wednesday night regular season game at home against a tired New Jersey Devils team, seemed like a fresh opportunity to ruin a jersey. And the darndest thing, they didn't. It wasn't smooth. It wasn't always smooth, but they won. And I gotta tell you, Leaf fans, if you've been watching these LFRs for a while, you know sometimes when the Leafs have a particularly embarrassing game where they, blow a 7-2 lead, I lament, imagine a moment's peace. I would love to just watch a hockey game. But with the Toronto Maple Leafs, you can't just watch a hockey game. Your heart rate is meant to jump up during hockey games. There are exciting moments. There are ups, there are downs, there are highs, there are lows. But there are times where the Leafs feel like the magic school bus and this entire fan base feels like Arnold. Because we go to the game or we watch the TV, we turn on a stream and we say, please, let this be a normal field trip! And they say, with the Leafs? No way! But this one, just really solid win. Just sort of a solid win, where they won because they should have won and held the fort at the end. I'm not saying it wasn't exciting, it was exciting. But it was exciting in like a normal way. It was, ooh, this game is tied with 5 minutes left exciting. Not, we're up by five, but this has traumatic incident written all over it exciting. I'll give you an example. Your conscious mind, think of the Centennial Classic. Centennial Classic, 2017 New Year's against the Detroit Red Wings. What is your lasting memory? Yep, your conscious mind is remembering Austin Matthews scoring to win it in overtime. That was exciting. But your subconscious mind, what happened before that? How did that game get to overtime? Now, if you don't remember, good for you, but I do! They blew a 4-1 lead with 1 second remaining! Now, you might call that exciting, and it is, but it isn't! And who do we even got in net for this? Mrazek! We got Peter Mrazek. Well, we'll see how that goes. Yes, Colin Blackwell, Leafs debut. Yes, Mark Giordano, Leafs debut. And those things are all well and good, but neither of those additions mean a thing unless the Leafs get a save. So yeah, Blackwell, cool. Giordano, even cooler, let's be honest. But Peter Mrazek is the story here. And there have been games over the past couple weeks where, yes, Shelgren has been far better than Mrazek, but I've gone, oh, the Leafs like you more. With the exception of a few mistakes, which any team is going to make, the Leafs played well for Shelgren. Mrazek, while he was bad, was also hung out to dry. In this one, Leafs outshoot the Devils 11-3 in the first. The Leafs were just kind of the better team for an entire 20 minutes. It's an interesting strategy. One way to calm down a goalie is to bore them. No goals, no penalties even, so we go to the second. Early in the second, the Leafs get a power play, and unfortunately, that power play is a big bucket of yuck. Engvall takes a trip on Jonas Siegenthaler, and oh no. Well, that should be okay. I have faith in the Leafs' penalty kill. Devils' power play features Damon Severson, a guy who Leafs fans routinely make fun of because he's always scoring on his own team against the Leafs. So naturally, he fires the puck randomly into the slot. It hits Ilya Lyubushkin and ends up in the net. Uno reverse card, 1-0 Devils. And I'm just like, oh, please don't affect Mrazek's confidence. Underrated moment from the second period, Michael Bunting shows that he is a true rat. True rats are not deterred by the score. There's a great slow-mo of PK Subban throwing the puck over the glass for a delay of game penalty, and a slow-mo of Michael Bunting just looking at him and going, ah! Underrated is a player's reaction to a puck over the glass penalty, but also underrated people who laugh at other players for taking a penalty. But again, the Leafs power play looking kind of awful. And Matthews with a hook on Nico Hischier. Now the Devils are back to the power play. This is the darndest thing. Matthews, continuing his heart bid, puts the Leafs on the advantage. Because remember, who scored that goal? Damon Severson? No! That was Ilya Lyubushkin's first as a Leaf. Only the Leafs score when they are on the penalty kill. And Ilya Mikheyev knows this. He gets sprung on a partial break that turns into a break because he is the world's fastest snake. Forehand, backhand, cobra! Scores to make it 1-1. The hands. Never seen a snake with such hands. His 13th of the season with everything he's been through. Honestly, is that the nicest goal he scored in the NHL? Good goal. Tie a game. A few minutes later, there were 5 goals in this game, and this was the only one scored by a Devil. This one was the sloppiest play of the game for the Leafs. The Devils. 2-on-1, basically. Sort of a standing still 2-on-1, if that makes sense. Justin Hall, the only guy back. He can't pick off the pass. And I just want to show you something. This wasn't a goal. The dude on the left, the Devil on the left, has the puck right there. That's not a goal. He did not score. Mrazek absolutely robs him, but unfortunately Justin Hall can't kick the puck away or whack the puck away or get the puck away at all. And on the rebound, Nico Hischier shovels it in. That's not Mrazek's fault at all. It's 2-1 Devils. Dude, that would have been one of the Leafs' saves of the season had that stood. So now we got the Leafs losing, and it's late in the period. They're losing at home. Losing to a tired Devils team. The power play doesn't look very good. Marner doesn't look very good. Marner doesn't look very good. And that's when Austin whispered, Mitch.
Yeah.
You know it's the next gen game, right?
It's tonight?
Yeah, you didn't notice the jerseys?
I thought it was just cool.
Yeah, they're cool, but just do the thing.
Yeah.
Mitch Marner remembered he's supposed to crush the next gen game. If the Leafs just call every home playoff game the next gen game, he might win the Conn Smythe. That line getting to work, Michael Bunting with the touch of the puck, but it's Matthews, Mwah Matthews, with the nasty pass to Mitch Marner in the slot. And this dude cranks it one-timer, his 27th goal of the season, which is a new career high, and he's got time to work. Leafs tie it up. Taking on Mitch Marner in the next gen game is like taking on The Undertaker at WrestleMania. And so, again, okay. It's tied, heading into the third. Now, in the third, we see why Kyle Dubas was so smart to get Mark Giordano. Because you see some people, well, sure, he was the captain. Sure, he won the Norris, but my goodness, Mark Giordano is in his late 30s. Yeah, well, here's what being a former captain in your late 30s gets you in the National Hockey League. You see, Mark Giordano was called for tripping. And so the ref did, you know, the arm up thing and they weed and blew the whistle, and then Mark Giordano had to go to the box. And when he got to the box, Mark Giordano said, respectfully, I think there's been a mistake. And the NHL referee said, yeah, they all say, do you have gray stubble? And Mark Giordano says, yes, in fact, I do. And the ref says, I'm sorry, there's been a mistake. No penalty. I got a few texts from people. Do I think that should have been a trip? Let me be clear. Giordano plays for the Leafs now, so no. Okay, very funny, Steve, but seriously, I am being serious. I said what I said. So, back half of the third period, Oh no. This one's not just a penalty, but it's a double minor, and it's to arguably the least best penalty killer in Ilya Mikheyev. Double minor for high-sticking Andreas Janssen. What are the Leafs gonna do without Ilya Mikheyev? They rely on Ilya Mikheyev, but Swedish! What's his name? Engvall! On the rush, Engvall comes in, and the Devils are like, is that William Nylander on the penalty kill? And they never recovered from it. That's not really what happened. Actually, what happened is Pierre Engvall happened to Dougie Hamilton. Where are you going? You're lost. You're literally dog water. You're playing on the ground against the Leafs' tallest player. What are you doing? Dougie Hamilton, after almost getting completely embarrassed by Mitch Marner earlier in the penalty kill, there was another opportunity he didn't look so confident on, and then this, defending from his stomach, woof! One of the worst power plays in human history, and Engvall outweighs Hamilton, outweighs Dawes, outweighs everybody, snipes it for his 11th. Can we talk about the emergence of Pierre Engvall? Dude, there were games earlier this season I was like, I don't even want this guy on my team. Should he play third or fourth line? How about no line? And all of a sudden, his presence on that third line with David Kampf has been one of the steadiest, it's one of the steadiest lines they've had in years. And he scores on the penalty kill.
6'5" every time he hits the ice and all that.
Seabiscuit off to the races and the Leafs take a 3-2 lead late. And then, you know what happened? You know what happened? Peace. Just peace. Peace. Mrazek held the fort. The Leafs held the fort. One of the Devils hit Pierre Engvall from behind with an empty net. Almost broke his neck. It was right in front of the ref. We're not going to talk about that because he's okay and the Leafs won. Great league. It's a great league. But it was just peaceful. Peaceful. They started to win and then they won. Makes my brain melt. Hooray. What a confidence builder for Peter Mrazek. What a good game for Mark Giordano. I like Colin Blackwell too. Let's answer some questions.
How come the refs love the Leafs so much?
Well, they love to take over a game, which means they love the attention, and the Leafs get the best ratings, so that's why they love the Leafs so much. Airtime, baby. How come Drew loves the Leafs so much? Probably because they gave him Nazem Kadri. Was Blackwell impressive? Yeah, no slander for Colin Blackwell, but everyone talks about the Leafs like they're a tiny team. They're not actually a tiny team. Almost all of them are 6 foot and up. The way people talk about the Leafs is like they're a team full of Colin Blackwells. And that's easy to think until Colin Blackwell shows up. He is listed at 5'9", and to that I ask, in what measurement? In what unit of measurement is he 5'9"? When did they make skates with stilts? No, he is not. But a good hockey player, he is. Listen, it's his first game with the team. I'm not expecting a Mona Lisa. He was a fourth liner. He was fast, agitating, got a scoring chance or two, eager to hit, not scared of being hit. That's a good player. I've liked him all the way back to his time on the Rangers. If you remember the podcast stuff that we did with the Seattle Kraken, I wanted the Kraken to take him from the Rangers, and then they did. Honestly, kind of surprised the Leafs were able to get him in a deal with Mark Giordano. It's good. Should the Leafs play shorthanded all the time? They seem to play better 4-on-5. Watching how good the Leafs' penalty kill is shows you how mental it is with this team. Like, when the Leafs start to crumble in those moments where they have multi-goal leads, like almost all of them are 5-on-5. Almost all of the goals they allow. There might even be a shorthanded goal in there. But their penalty kill has this ridiculous confidence. I mean, obviously great ability, they're fast, they're aggressive, but in order to play fast and aggressive, you gotta believe. Like, you gotta commit to what you're doing. You can't be like bashful about going on a 2-on-1 when you're down a man. So I don't wish for the Leafs to play 4-on-5 all the time, but I wish them to play with the same gusto all the time. Successful day. Also, Engvall is an absolute beast. Check out Jordan with, who is that? It's, oh, he took a photo with Albert Einstein. Adam, I love the hair, bud. I love the hair. I'm just messing with you. I can't be mean to Adam. Him and Jesse got me this. My birthday was weeks ago. Like, you might look at it like, oh man, you know, oh, they missed your birthday weeks ago. No, that's so thoughtful. I expect gifts on my birthday. All right, you know what? You know when I don't expect gifts? What day is it? It was March 23rd. My birthday's March 12th. You think I was expecting a gift on March 23rd? No. So it meant
I don't know. I'm not going to say it meant more, but I was delighted. What's better than friends? They know I needed it. What's better than friends? I'm hugging myself because they got me this jersey, and it's like I'm hugging them. Anyway, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like. If you like this video, click subscribe. If you really liked it, tell all your friends. Peter Mrazek for Vezina, Colin Blackwell for Selke, Mark Giordano for Norris, and is a Leaf. And please wear this more than once.